Good afternoon, boys and ghouls. Slash is like, this is Freaks of the Fright. This is your humble and hearty host, the Horror Heathen, of the Horror Heathen YouTube channel and the podcast South Jersey Horror. Today, I am accompanied by a very, very awesome person. Her name is Spencer Madison. She seems like a really cool individual, and I want to be friends with her. I really do. Spencer Madison is an American comedy horror actress. Best known for her roles as Collins in Phantom Fun World and Izzy Wagner in the anticipated New Age Exorcist, The Demons Within. With several films being released in early 2023, and even more slated for production, she's about to explode onto the horror scene as her favorite final girl and potentially even your favorite new villain. You hear that, people? A new villain's coming out of the works. Better get ready for it. So you, at the age of 12, you began theater acting as a creative outlet and found a love for performing. You joined the Missoula Traveling Children's Theater for two seasons, performing at the notable and historical Midland Theater in Newark, Ohio. Is it Newark or Newark?
Newark, yeah.
Okay, because there's a Newark, New Jersey, too, so I had to ask. By the age of 21, I'm maybe doing this wrong. You written and created numerous screenplays and that are ready for TV pilots in the hopes to break into the industry as a writer. And by the age of 27, you created and starred in an award-winning short film directed by Ashley Minnie. And you plan to continue creating content for the LGBTIQ community so that proper representation in the media is achieved. And that I have a lot of respect for you for doing so, because that is a community that is so underrated and so misjudged all the time. And it's annoying, but we're not going to get into that right now because I do not like to talk about politics and religion. So, ladies and gentlemen, the beautiful, the awesome, the talented Spencer Madison, how are you doing today?
I'm very good. How are you?
So let's talk about The Demons Within. I want to know what this movie is about, because I saw the preview in the trailer and I'm like, dude, this looks like a very awesome movie. Yeah. And I love movies about possessions. That's my favorite subgenre of all the horror industry. And I'm like, yes, this is going to happen.
Yeah, it sure is.
So fill us in, please.
Yeah, so the movie was actually supposed to be made years ago, but COVID happened. And they had a completely different cast at the time. And then the writer, Roberta Griffin, she's an amazing writer. She's an amazing woman. And she wanted to get the story out there. So she found very willing and motivated and dedicated crew to make it happen, essentially. And they recast everybody. Well, mostly everybody. And we ended up filming it over the course of about 14 days. And it all revolves around a girl named Izzy Wagner, who I play. She's a 17-year-old who gets possessed. And she's kind of, it's one of those stories where you kind of have to wonder if she's losing her damn mind or if she's actually possessed by something that's otherworldly, essentially. And it's a really deep story, and it has a lot of symbolism between like mother-daughter relationships. So my mom, who's played by Alicia Seaton, a wonderful actor, who my favorite scenes that I've done in the whole movie were with her. And I had a lot of fun terrorizing her. Essentially, I really did.
Who doesn't?
That's
fantastic. So what else can you tell us about the movie? How long did it take to film this movie?
It took like 14 days, I think was the official number. But like I said, I mean, to make this movie, it was years in the making for this writer and some of these crew members. They've just been hit after hit with, you know, COVID stuff and getting funding and then having to recast. So they finally made it. And luckily they cast me as their main character. And it's slated to come out next year. And I think that it's going to hit some people pretty hard. I focused my character on psychologically ruining the audience. So
that I'm looking forward to it because all about it's the way you describe that. I'm like, yes, I'm thinking in my head. I'm like, okay, now I might have to skip work to come see this movie.
Yeah,
I'm gonna call in sick just to go see it. So
it was so fun, and it was the first time that I was able to wear the sclera contacts, the all black, and that was so fun because nobody could tell where I was looking. So I could be looking like right at somebody and just speaking in between takes, and they would interrupt me and they say, I need you to stop. I need you to maybe take them out or close your eyes or put sunglasses on or something, because I can't look at you right now. And I think I might have fed into that a little bit too much, because like I said, I loved to terrorize my co-stars. Loved it.
Wow. I have to call him Dean and Sam Winchester to come to.
Yeah, it was so fun. So we had one of my co-stars, her name is Jess Napier, and she was number 5 in Stranger Things this last season. And she was one of the children in the facility with 11. And she actually played like one of the bullies that was bullying 11. And she was so fun, but there's a scene with her, and I'm not really supposed to give much away, so I'll be very vague with this. But there's a scene where my character goes out of their way to break them emotionally. And they do it multiple times, but there's a specific scene that even the director, Stephanie Hensley, and our AD, Brandon, had to look away during filming because they were so distressed. And I couldn't watch the scene. I was shown like a clip of it, and I didn't watch it yet because it was distressing to perform as an actor. And I can only imagine what it's going to look like with all the angles that happens. It's going to be bad.
Are we talking to Stephanie next week? And she's probably going to tell me all about it too. So,
oh, are you talking to Stephanie?
Yes, next Friday.
Good.
I am. So
good.
Yeah, she's, you know, I asked her if she wanted to join in on this interview, but she's like, nope. She's like, you deserve the spotlight in this one.
Oh,
so,
good.
And I totally agree. I had no problem with that. I understood. So, I'm speechless next. I don't know what to talk about. For once, I'm speechless. This is so weird.
I'm really excited for people to see it because as a lead character, as an actor, there's a lot of pressure put on you, just like subconscious pressure, not put on me by anybody specifically or by like crew or anything, but it's pressure to perform the piece the way that the writer envisioned it. And I didn't know this, but Roberta, the writer, came to set one day. I didn't know she was coming. And she showed up during one of the most intense scenes, and I'm like in it. And by the time like they say action in a scene, my character's so dark that I emotionally kind of black out and just perform it. And then when they say cut, I come back, and I've never experienced that before. So when they said cut and I like come back to life, essentially, I look over and the writer is there. And I was a little like self-conscious because I really wanted to do well for her. You know, I wanted her to be proud because I wasn't the original Izzy. So when they recast, there was a pressure put on me that I wanted to not be better than the original Izzy, but be someone that a character and an actor that they could be proud of, essentially.
Yeah. So you want to live up to their expectation. I get it.
Yeah.
So, and I'm sure you did. So
I hope so. Just by
seeing that short clip with you on the bed and the lady trying to stick the needle in your arm. And it was fantastic. I was in shock. I was like, dude, I mean, you that spot right there, I'm convinced that you're possessed. So
yeah.
And I'm like, she is a good actress. I am not gonna lie.
Thank you.
So if you could pull that off, I know I've talked to many other actors and actresses who played possessed roles in movies, and they say it's not easy trying to play that kind of role because you have to put yourself in the mind frame, the mindset. And you have to think about, okay, what's my next move going to be? And you're doing it so hard and so well, you don't want to disappoint your fans. You don't want to disappoint the director and the writer, all this stuff. And I have a good feeling that you performed exceptionally well.
Thank you.
So, and Liz, I cannot wait to see it. And I'm actually getting jittery just thinking about it.
I think that people are going to really like this movie. I think that people are probably going to hate my character because I didn't focus on being a likable character. I focused on playing this girl Izzy as real as possible, and she said some really mean things. Like she said, she went to the lowest point that a person can go to hurt someone. And in the clip, I say something, and that was improv, my line, when I'm standing up and I'm like confronting my mom after she tries to stab me with a needle. That was improv. And I remember when they yelled cut, Jake, the DP, was like, what the fuck? Because like I tried to say the lowest of the low. You know, I didn't want to be likable. So wait, where in this interview are you showing this clip?
Right after we get done talking.
Okay, so people are gonna know what I'm talking about, because it's nasty. It's just, I had to play a nasty character. And you know when you watch a movie or a TV show and you're like, I don't like the main character. Like, I think that's a very common thing, to not like the main character, because they have to go through an arc. So it's really common to be like, oh, this main character, this protagonist is like so unlikable. And when I was younger, I used to hate that. I used to hating the main character. But now as an actor, I really like being a main character and being a character people love to hate. So
you gotta do what you gotta do to cater to the audience. I mean,
yeah,
if it means going that low, I mean, that means you did your job.
Yeah.
You do what you're supposed to do. So if they don't like it, they just get over it.
Yeah. Yeah. And Stephanie Hensley was really nice and supportive of me improving or changing lines, as long as it stuck with the storyline and didn't change anything. She was really kind about letting me change the lines to be as nasty as possible, because Roberta, she's an amazing writer and she brought these characters to life essentially. But when you get, she wasn't on set. So the majority of the time. So when an actor gets on set and they become that character, they like, for me, I took the reins and I was like, this is what she would say. Like, I get where Roberta, the writer, was going with this dialogue, but this is better because this is where Izzy's at emotionally. And so Stephanie was really nice about letting me be the character and take responsibility with the dialogue. And Roberta, when she came to set, she was also really, really supportive of that too. So that was nice.
That's cool. That's awesome. So being assertive, not only being assertive, but digging into what you got to do in order to discover and to create this persona, it makes you a talented person. And there's no doubt in my mind that you're going to win an award for this position, this role. So
that would be cool.
If you don't win an award, call me and I'll start blowing people's phones up. I mean,
I put a lot of emotional investment in this movie. I didn't hold back. I mean, I cried and screamed and said nasty things and was possessed for 14 days. And by the end of it, when I came back home, it took me about a week to come down from that, because it was a really dark place that I had to go to. There was this one night where we got the local EMT and paramedic team to come in for a scene. And it was one of the most intense scenes that I've ever done in my life. And I blacked out completely. Apparently it was like a 10-minute take, because I just like kept going. And like the things that they're saying about this, I haven't seen the take or the scene yet, but the things they're saying about it was like, that's not Spencer. Like that was not you. And I don't remember even doing the scene. And before we did the scene, I remember feeling very manic and very jittery, and I kept pacing. And I think I was scaring my co-stars because I had the black eyes in, and I was made up, and I was dressed a certain way, and I looked a certain way, and I was pacing back and forth and talking to myself and like getting my lines down. And by the time they yelled action, I just blacked out. And I think I scared my co-stars a little bit. I know I scared my on-screen boyfriend, who's played by Shane Thompson. He's a phenomenal actor, but he, I think, was a little like, damn.
How's it go again?
Damn.
So it's what you're saying is it feels like you're actually really possessed by something, which I know is not true, but I mean, sometimes people have to do that in order to play and to get into character. So,
yeah.
But
yeah, I'm sure, a dark place.
But I'm sure on screen you look absolutely amazing, and playing that role, I guarantee you. You hear that, public? You can kiss my ass. I don't care what you think. I think she's gonna be amazing in that role.
Thank you. Yeah, it would be cool to win some awards. I want all of my co-stars to win awards. I think that everybody did just such an amazing job, and it had a lot to do with where we all were mentally with the story, because it was so taxing to do. And there was a scene between my on-screen boyfriend, Shane, his character Luke, and Jeff Davis, who plays Glenn, my dad. And there was a scene between these two, and it was really intense. And Shane, like Luke, went there in this role, in the scene. And he like partially lost his voice. He was like just sipping throat coat tea and in between takes, because like he was just like so into it. And Alicia Seaton, by the last day, I was worried that I had just broken. She just broke. I was so scared that she was like not going to be okay, because a lot of my scenes with her are very tumultuous and toxic, but it was fun to do.
I bet. But I mean,
I hope she's okay to this day.
Who doesn't want to do a possessed role? I mean, God damn it. I would like to be in that movie as a possessed role, but I heard I suck at acting, so that's probably never going to happen for me.
It was definitely on my actor's bucket list to be possessed. I have a few things that I want to do, and being possessed was one of them. So
good, check that off. Done.
Yep. Yep.
So wearing the black contacts, scaring your coworkers, your co-actors, making up your own lines, improvising, these are all good attributes for a movie. So
yeah,
is there anything else that was very arduous about doing this movie, like any scenes that were hard to do, or did anyone trip and fall on something, how many retakes on some of the scenes or anything like that?
Honestly, the hardest scene was between Jess, who plays Jen, my best friend, her and I. That scene was really hard to do, because when we were done, I wanted to ask her, are you okay? But you can't do that really until that scene is completely done filming, because you can't, like, I was thinking of her emotional mindset, and like, I don't want to like hurt her and then bring her back. And like, it's like a toxic relationship where I like abuse someone and then I'm like, are you okay? And like, you know what I mean? Like, I wanted her to stay hurt. And then when we were done with the scene, I could be like, oh my God, I'm so sorry. Are you okay? But that was really hard to do. And I think it was really hard for the crew to do as well.
It's like, but I just slapped the shit out of you. Are you okay?
Oh, it was worse than physical. Oh God. It was emotional for sure. But I think the hardest thing to do on this set specifically for all of us was the simple things, because we were so intense the whole time. It was the simple scenes that had no intensity that we struggled with. Like, for example, I didn't know what to do with my hands in one scene, because I wasn't like choking someone out or like being a dick. Can I say that?
Yes, it's fine.
Okay. Okay. So it was the simple things like, what do I do with my hands? Or like even smiling was really hard because it felt wrong. And I think that a lot for a lot of my co-stars, it was hard too. Like, I remember Alicia asking a question that seemed silly at the time, but now that I think back on it, I really agree with the question. And her question was, what's my motivation for drinking this water? And like, that's such a silly question. Like, just drink the fucking water. But like now when you look back on it, it's like, that was hard for all of us to be simple. Like, what's our motivation for putting my hand on my hip? You know what I mean? Like, because it was so simple and we were so used to being intense and hard and like, it's funny to think back on of all of our struggles and the simple things being what we struggle the most with.
I get it. I totally get it.
Yeah.
So having humor on set is good, especially when it comes up to a dark movie. So
yeah, there was a lot of humor on set, which was really nice. Like you said, for such a dark movie, we all really got along. There wasn't one person who didn't fit that mold. The crew, the cast, we were all handpicked by the universe, and it was just perfect. It was perfect harmony. There was never anything. And I think even the people who came in, like the celebrities who came in for the movie, we had Deborah Foreman from Valley Girl and April Fool's Day. And we had Andrew Gower and Ryan Lambert from Monster Squad. And they fit the mold. They were only there for like a day or two days. And they just fit the mold right when they came in. So I think it was whatever universe, gods, or whatever you believe in, like they handpicked us and brought us together. And that was perfect harmony. It was so good.
You said Andrew Gower?
Yeah.
I'm trying.
Andre.
Sorry. And, yeah. Andre. I'm trying so hard to get an interview with him. We've been corresponding back and forth with emails. And his mother happened. So I get it. So yeah. We had to reschedule. But if you see him again, let him know that I'm thinking about him.
Yeah, of course. Yeah.
And I'm still trying to get the interview.
Of course. Yeah. I bet Ryan Lambert would be down too. He played Rudy in Monster Squad. So
yes, I actually emailed him as well, but hey, it is what it is. So
yeah.
So is there anything else you can tell us about the movie that you're allowed to say that the directors and producers are like, okay, you can say this, but you cannot say this. Enlighten us with something.
I actually don't know how much I can say. So like, I'm going to allow Stephanie next week to give you any exclusive information regarding release or trailers or anything, because I have no idea. It's been so hush hush, and they've been just Stephanie and Jake and Jeff and Cody and the whole crew, they've been grinding and hustling away at this movie. So I'm going to allow Stephanie to give you any more information, I think.
Well, you could pass on my congratulations to the cast and crew, because this looks like it's going to be an amazing movie. And like I said, I will never pass up a good movie about possessions, because that is my favorite subgenre in the entire horror community. As you see, there's a Exorcist poster right there behind me.
Oh, yeah, I see it.
So, but to you, mainly, being the main antagonist in the movie and the main female lead, congratulations to you and wrapping this up. And I hope you do win an award for this film. If you do not, I'm going to write to some people and just be an asshole. And say, hey, give her an award.
All right. Okay.
I've been told I'm very annoying and persistent. I'm going to keep doing that.
Hey, that gets you far. It does.
So, yes. Pending any questions you have for me, or if you said this you want to say, we can go ahead and wrap this up if you want to.
Yeah, of course. I don't believe I have any questions. I've been watching / listening to your episode, so I'm pretty caught up, I think.
Sweet. So yeah. Is there anything else you can tell the audience out there about any upcoming projects, any upcoming movies that they should know about besides The Demons Within?
Wolf Hollow, which will be released April 1st at the Hollywood Theater in Pittsburgh. And then Phantom Fun World is looking at a March release, undisclosed, undetermined location for that. I think it's kind of hush hush right now. And In the Shadows will be released sometime next year, and Fields Adrift will be released sometime next year. Yeah, and then I have like 7 movies coming up, or that I'll be filming over the course of next summer, fall. So
keeping yourself busy, huh?
Yeah, full time actor is what you got to do.
Fun Phantom Fun World. What's that about? I saw that on your IMDb page as well.
Yeah, that's a really fun movie. That was probably one of my favorite sets to be on. Tori Jones from Jonestown Film. He wrote this amazing movie about these friends who get stalked and killed by a theme park mascot. And Phantom Fun World is the theme park, and the Phantom is the mascot. And there's a whole backstory to him. And it's a very, like, it feels kind of like Rob Zombie on ecstasy. Like the color scheme.
I'm trying to imagine that. Is it more like I want to say H.P. Lovecraft, but probably not. But
no, the color schemes are very neon purples and greens and blues and flashing lights. It's like the carnival, but the dialogue and the violence and the gore is very Rob Zombie. So
another movie to look forward to watching too.
Yeah.
So, all right. So you play Izzy Wagner in the movie, in the upcoming movie, Demons Within. Thank you so much for joining me. I really do appreciate it. You've been remarkable and fun to talk to. And I hope we can be friends on Facebook, because that would be the most excellent thing ever.
Yeah, I think we are friends on Facebook.
We are? I think I'd check that. I have so many people following me right now. It's ridiculous. I've gotten so many friends requests the past 2 months. I'm like, okay, slow down, people. Pump the brakes, all right?
Yeah.
So, yeah. All right, cool. Ladies and gentlemen. The beautiful, the talented Spencer Madison. Check out the upcoming clip of her in this next movie. Not the next movie. The upcoming clip in The Demons Within right after the interview. And thank you so much for joining me. You've been most excellent. And I wish you the best in your career. And I hope you get tons of awards for your roles in all these movies that you're doing. And please do keep in touch.
Thank you so much for having me. I had a really fun time. So
you too. I mean, yeah. All right. Later, dude. I'll talk to you later. Have a good evening. And take care.
You as well.
You can help me by cutting your daughter in half so I can have double the fuck.
Izzy! Please, I know you're in there, Izzy! Izzy! Izzy!
She's not here anymore.